The molecular is very simple, although it sounds complex. It just means correcting the molecular balance in the body. We're all made up of molecules. If we're made up of the correct ones, if we eat the correct ones or take in the correct ones, we have a much better chance of being healthy or recovering from illness than if we take in the wrong ones. So orthomolecular medicine is basically the use of natural substances that occur in the body, and that includes diet, and it includes supplements to the diet. It might include vitamins, minerals, amino acids, fatty acids, the essential nutrients that we have.
6 months after taking the vitamins, I was reading the newspaper saying, what can I do? There was a job offer to teach skiing, and I had been on the racing team at university. I phoned them up and I told them my background. They hired me and I taught skiing that winter, and I wasn't on any medication whatsoever, just the mega vitamin therapy of Dr. Carl Pfeiffer.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, I went and walked into Dr. Hoffer, and he gave me the HOD test, the Hoffer-Osmond diagnostic mm-hmm. test. He said, you're schizophrenic. Mm-hmm. And it just floored me. I thought, what? Oh, there's a name for it, you know? And he said, yeah, and I want to put you on the B3, B6, zinc, and vitamin C mega doses. So I did that, and off sugar and... Mm-hmm. You know, the whole nutrition thing.
It's hard to cut out, isn't it?
Yeah, the sugar was hard. But for 3 months, I was religious. I didn't even eat ketchup. I didn't. If anything had sugar in it, I didn't touch it. And I still thought, well, I still don't feel any better. And he said, so I went back in to see Dr. Hoffer after about 3 months, and he said, well, why don't you take the HOD test again and just see? So I took it, and there was a 30-point difference.
Wow.
I had actually improved, but I wasn't feeling like mm-hmm. I was. So then later on, another 3 months went by, and then I got really sick.
Mm-hmm.
I think it was all the toxins coming out.
Mm-hmm.
And I went into hospital for 3 months.
Mm-hmm.
And he upped my meds. I had some shock treatments, and that mm-hmm. seemed to do the trick.
Great, and are you staying on the medication?
I'm on low meds. Mm-hmm. I've stayed on all. I've added vitamins of my own over the years.
Great. Yeah.
So the combination treatment is the best, because with the combination treatment, once you have used the drug to help them improve, you maintain that improvement by the use of vitamins, so you can now withdraw the drug, get rid of the drugs entirely, or take such a small amount that there are no side effects, and now they're able to function perfectly well.
And when I tried to get them at the hospital to give Darren the treatments that he suggested, B3 and C and all those things, and of course at the hospital they said, oh no, that's toxic, those vitamins are toxic.
As if the pills are...
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
The pills are really good for you. Don't take those vitamins.
My mom brought the vitamins to the hospital, and they actually blackmailed me to not take my medication. So they would say, you don't get any more help if you don't take your medication.
That's probably the best thing that happened.
It was the best thing that happened for the flip reverse, because then what happened was I found out about vitamins, and 3 weeks after taking B3 at a high dosage, B3 being parent and being schizophrenic, started to clear my side effects, my symptoms, and they lowered the medication.
With any treatment, including orthomolecular treatment, one has to take into account the potential side effects. And there are two types of side effects. There are the major or life-threatening side effects, and there are the minor inconveniences. For example, with niacin, there's a flush. When they first start taking it, they start flushing, which is hot, and they're red and itchy. And if they don't know what's going to happen, they get frightened. It's a minor inconvenience. It's not a major threat.
By this point, I'd read about $150, and something was starting to sink in. And the books from Europe actually said that depression is being treated using ginkgo and other things like St. John's wort, and they work. And the beauty of why they work, they have minimal adverse effects.
St. John's wort became very popular, and I had been using it already in my practice, and I really wanted to share the experience that I had had with it, because it's so important for the medical profession to know that there is a very, very good substitute for